Hey, I am coming to you live from Chevron, Marat HaMachpelah, the cave of the Patriarchs. Right behind me, you see the Herodian stone. Looks a little like the Kotel itself because built by the same individual, Herod the Great. And we brought MGE here today to be able to pray by the cave of the Patriarchs of Abraham and Sarah, of Jacob, of Leah, Isaac, and Rebecca. And tonight is Chodesh Av in Israel. Tonight is the beginning of the saddest month on the Jewish calendar. And we're living in interesting times because on one hand, of course, we are beginning to mourn the destruction of our temple. The first and second temples were destroyed on Tisha B'Av, and the 9 days leading up to the day of Tisha B'Av begin the beginning, if you will, of the sad times when we decrease in our joy and in our happiness. At the same time, we've been traveling around Israel and we can walk freely into this building and pray by the graves of our patriarchs and matriarchs. And we can walk around and see Israeli soldiers in Hebron. It's unbelievable. This is one of the most important places to be as a Jew. And before 1967, we couldn't come here. We saw a video of individuals who used to stand right there. You see that individuals walking up and against the wall, that's all where Jews were allowed to pray. And now we went into the building there and we were there for about 2 hours and you could just walk around freely. We've got a bulletproof bus and we've got an armed guard. I'm not saying things are simple or easy here, but we're back. And so even though we are mourning the destruction of the temple and we need to do that, we need to recognize we're living in very, very special times. And those special times require us and demand of us to be grateful to God, to the IDF, and to this great country that we're privileged to walk around in. At the same time, we need to recognize that something is still missing. The temple is still laying in ruins, and we don't have all of the Jewish people here, and there's still a lot of strife and warfare, and we're still praying and yearning for universal peace and brotherhood. The Mashiach has not come. And that's why we need these 9 days leading up to Tisha B'Av. On one hand, therefore, we should be grateful, we should be thankful, we should realize we're living in special times. We've got this place back. On the other hand, we need to recognize we're not quite there. And perhaps, therefore, through our mourning and through our reflecting over the temple's destruction and what we can do to improve ourselves and the world around us, we can bring back the third temple and have it all with the coming of the Mashiach. Shabbat Shalom. Thank you for listening in Chevron.